In this video, I'll have another look at this liquid electrolyte tape TEMU sent me as part of our first collaboration. I am making this second video because first video was shot just after receiving the items and this takes a while to cure. But now these test applications have had about 1 week to cure. Like I said and showed in the previous video, these are available on TEMU at quite low price. If you haven't used TEMU app before, you can use my code in search bar or click my link to get free gifts with qualifying order. This is the power supply wire that I reinforced in the first video. It looks okay, I applied the liquid electrolyte tape over the strain relief and the wire. This seems to have tried to have this hard rubber feel to it. It does bend a little bit, but not much. I can see tearing already. Let's test more aggressive bends, which could happen if device with this attached will be moved a lot. And making a hard bend on the wire breaks this stuff. That is the original right there. This is quite stiff, sticks nicely to the cable, but it's not as elastic as I would like in this application. Here is another cable with thicker layer of this liquid electrolyte tape. Regular two-wire cable of DC power supply. The plug has this kind of strain relief on it, but I know these aren't very durable in long run, so I've added two layers of this stuff around it. Again, it feels like hard rubber, not plastic, that's good. It does bend a little bit, but not very much. It may work in some cases, but if there's strong pull on the cable, this can break. But I think this stuff did better job in this second test, while still not perfect. Next I have two different PCBs coated with this liquid tape. This first one is the one I applied in the previous video. While I just quickly brushed it without smoothing the surface, end result looks nice after a while. The liquid tape has taken the shape of the components and PCB underneath it, but the layer is still thick and uniform. One thing to note is there's a hole in this coating at the end of the largest component. It may be hard to see in the video, but the PCB is visible. This liquid electrolyte tape is liquid enough to smooth the surface and go into cavities, but because of surface tension and skin that is formed in just a couple of minutes, it won't spread outside very much. Next I'll try to use screwdriver and knife to peel this stuff off. First with screwdriver. It actually has stuck pretty well. I can scrape this stuff off piece by piece, but it takes some effort. Let's try with other one, where I applied the liquid tape more thoroughly. Now we are talking. The coating starts to stretch and bend. Maybe I can pull from that corner and pull the whole thing off in one piece. Well, not quite, but almost. Oh, that's interesting. It's not just places where the components and their legs were. Look at this. Slightly higher traces and silkscreen text, as well as text on those ICs, are visible on the bottom of this peeled coating. That's really cool. The first PCB has so many small components side by side, I believe that is why it's tearing to pieces more easily. Then I have a tip for applying this stuff. Like I said, this is thick, sticky goop. It cures by first forming a skin and then rest of the goop cures slowly. While the inside is curing, it is semi-liquid and it will keep changing its shape for a while. When coating something with this, it's most important to make sure it sticks to all the areas you want and there are no gaps or holes. The surface will smoothen automatically, but the perimeter will take its shape quite quickly. For best results, it's advised to build up with a couple of layers if one isn't enough. Wait for the skin to form, i.e. surface not be sticky, before next layer. Here I applied more than I was going to, so I'll try to take some off. Here's example of gap that won't close. I can see the side of that smaller component. It will stay that way unless I brush over it again. On the other sides, the coating is properly touching the PCB and there are no gaps. So I'll just add a little bit more to that one side where the gap is. One advice I have heard many times is to somehow improve the seal in the can. Can is metal and so is the cap, but there's no seal between them. Solvents evaporate over time and this will dry in the can. One idea people have used is adding some of this liquid tape between the can and cap. Either let it set before inserting the cap and you may be able to reuse that. Or insert the cap right away and make more of a single-use seal for the longer storage. Anyway, if you have tips to share about this product, go on and leave a comment. See you next video. Thanks. Bye.